Hi everyone, I'm Atin Bansal, and today I'll be talking to you about VSTS Wiki. Unfortunately, Sandeep was not able to join us. He's the VSTS Wiki owner, but you can contact either of us on the Twitter handles listed here for any feedback or questions that you have. Before I jump into the demo, I want to talk about why we created VSTS Wiki. We wanted to make it very easy for teams to create process, project, and product level documentation in a very simplified manner. Let's also talk about the three underlying technologies that help us create VSTS Wiki. First being Git. Git is a technology that is used worldwide for millions of source control repositories, and that's the backing of VSTS Wiki as well. The second is Markdown. Markdown has become a documentation standard across multiple platforms, and that is what we use in VSTS Wiki. And the third one is Elasticsearch, which gives us the power to index everything that you put into the wiki and make it discoverable. So let's go into the demo. For the demo, I'll be using two personas, John, who's a business analyst, and Jessica, who's a developer. John wants simplified yet rich experiences for his documentation. However, Jessica, who's a code developer, wants something that she's very familiar with. She doesn't want to come out into a separate space to do her documentation. She wants something which aligns with what she uses, which is IDE most of the time, supports workflows that she's used to, and is able to cater to her API and SDK documentation needs. One other need that both John and Jessica have is ubiquitous discovery. They both want their documentation that they write to be discovered by everybody else. So let's see how VSTS Wiki enables you to do this. We'll start off with John, John's persona. I'll move over to my demo project and assume that John comes and clicks on this Wiki tab. He sees two CTAs, create Wiki and publish code as Wiki. We'll come to publish code as Wiki later. Let's just go ahead and click on create Wiki for now. What happened in the background here is that a Git repo got provisioned for this Wiki. However, John is totally oblivious to that. He sees a nice page which is calling him to put in a page title. So let's put in a page title called My First Page and save it. And let's close this. And as you can see, the page has been created and it shows up on the right hand side in sort of like the table of contents that we build up automatically for you. Let's create a new page now. And so I want to quickly talk about what are the capabilities of Wiki that we provide. Obviously, you can start using the normal Markdown syntax, if I can spell right. But as you can see, we actually have a live preview pane. Anything you write here shows up here with how it would actually look to the end user. Now, I feel this is a pretty great thing because otherwise, what I have to do is I have to type something and hope that it's right, and then save it, click on preview in some other place, and actually see it, and then say, oh, this doesn't look good, let me go back and edit it again. However, here, you are actually able to change things right away because you're able to see it on the right-hand side. So let's assume that we are creating a wiki page and we want to link it to some other page in the wiki. Here on the top, we have quick shortcuts that you can use. So I'll quickly use the shortcut and I'll say link to first page. Still can't type. And then as soon as I come into the actual page, VSTS Wiki shows you all the pages in the wiki, and you can search and find the page that you're looking for and link it. Now I could have also linked the same thing by doing the notation myself. And again, I get the same power of search to find the page and link the page. Or I could have gone to my table of contents and dragged and dropped the page here, and it will still create a link for you, as you can see on the right hand side. So what else other than links that we put into the wiki pages? Definitely pictures is something that I like to put in my wiki pages. However, adding pictures to a Git repository is very, very hard. I have to take a snap. I have to save it to disk, I have to upload it to my Git repo, and then reference it from my Markdown page. In VSTS Wiki, it's much simpler. So assume that this is a page that you want to take a snap of. I just do a new in my snip tool, take a snap, come here, Control V, and done. I have the link to the image here, and I have the actual preview of the image right here on the page. Few seconds, that's it. Also, with the power of KTeX, we have brought in mathematical formula support to Wiki. So I can simply do E equals MC square. And as you can see on the right hand side, it has become the E equal to MC square, a formula that actual mathematicians can look at and understand. That's a simple formula, you might say. So let me copy and paste a much more real world example. There, I just pasted a much more interesting formula, and you have the right mathematical notation for it appearing on the right hand side. Let me switch over to a different wiki that I had created some time back and show you the power of what Markdown and embedded HTML that we support can do. You can create pages like this or like this using the power of Markdown and HTML in VSTS Wiki. So one thing inherent to wikis is ordering of pages and hierarchy of pages. That's very simple to do in VSTS Wiki. I can click on a page and quickly create a subpage and save it. And as you can see, I have subpages now within Azure Active Directory. I can move this page around to become a subpage of somebody else. As you see, the other problem that comes around with moving pages is that links get broken very easily. So I'll dismiss this dialog. But when you're moving around pages in a wiki and the pages are interlinked with each other, it's very easy to have broken links where a reference of a link has been broken because the page has moved. So now what VSTS Wiki allows you to do is, if I move this page over to, say, being a subpage of VSTS Home, it allows you to check for effective links on the rest of the pages and brings out not just page links that might be broken with your move, but also work item links that will get broken with your move. And instead of you having to go fix it, it actually fixes it for you and then moves the page. So all I have to say is fix and move. And now VSTS Wiki is going off fixing the pages and then making my page a subpage of the Wiki homepage. So while John was working on the VSTS Wiki UI, Jessica, who is our core developer, like I said, doesn't want to work in the UI. She wants to work in the IDE. Here, Jessica could see the URL of the wiki and actually clone it to her desktop, take it offline and work on wiki pages like she would work on any code file and come back and create a pull request for the wiki documentation. As simple as that. So we cater to both John's persona and Jessica's persona. However, when we interviewed personas like Jessica, we realized that it's not just the need to take wiki pages offline. Jessica already has a bunch of documentation stored in the code repository alongside her actual code. This is API level documentation, SDK level documentation that she's been writing for a long time. But there are four problems that these personas run into. Number one, anybody who wants to read their documentation actually has to sift through all the code and find the documentation. Number two, if the product has multiple versions, the documentation is very, very hard to maintain. Number three, there is no ordering of files in a Git repository, and Wiki is inherently built on ordering. And number four, there is no easy way to discover the pages and the documentation that have been written in a code repository. So let's see how VSTS Wiki addresses these four problems. I'll go back to the original project that we were working in. And I'll go to code. And as you can see, there has been some code which is being written. And what I know is there are also product level documentation that is residing alongside the code. So to publish this documentation to Wiki, I'll go to Wiki and click on Publish Code as Wiki. That's it. You select the repo from which you want the documentation to be picked up, the branch, the folder, which is docs ref conceptual, and we enter a wiki name and click publish. That's it. What is happening now is we are actually going through the folder and the subfolder specified by you, finding all the markdown files and creating a wiki for you from those pages. Now, that doesn't mean that we copied these pages over into a wiki. These are pages which are still residing in that code repo, but have become so much easier to now read and go through for anybody who is trying to find documentation for the product. Now, we talked about versions. Assume that this product also had a version 0.7 that had shipped some time back. And very similar to the way the documentation was written now, it was also written for that version. VSTS Wiki makes it very, very simple now to publish multiple versions of documentation for the same product. All I have to do is to click publish new version, point to the branch which has the version that has the documentation, and click update. Done. Anybody who now lands on this page can see that there are two versions of this product and this documentation, master and version 0.7, and choose accordingly. The third problem, as we talked about, is ordering of files. In Git repositories, there is no inherent ordering of files. And so the wiki is just a flat structure of pages that you have on the Git repository. However, you can change that in VSTS Wiki. Let me go back to docs ref conceptual and add a file here called .order. This is a file that VSTS Wiki uses to maintain the hierarchy and ordering of pages on the wiki side. So here, let's assume that we just want Node SDK Azure installed to be the first page that shows up. And I will commit this and done. Now when I go back to wiki to version 7, as you can see, the Node SDK Azure install is the first page that shows up. The last thing I want to talk about is discovery. Documentation is useless if nobody else can find it and see it. And so here, using the search box on the top, you can find the documentation that you just published from code repository over to wiki. So if I search for Azure Node, you see all the pages that have Azure Node in them, regardless of whether it's in the title or in the actual body of the page, and makes the wiki pages much more discoverable and helps people find what they're looking for. So going back to our deck, in summary, VSTS Wiki allows you to create project, process, or developer documentation in a very easy and simplified manner. It supports Markdown, uses the power of Git, and enables you to have ubiquitous discovery of all your wiki pages. If you want to know more about VSTS Wiki, go to akka.ms/devopswiki and feel free to contact us, either me or Sandeep, anytime you have questions or feedback on VSTS Wiki. Thank you so much.